More than 100 years have come and gone since that day in 1845 when an Indian-inhabited wilderness boasting a few white settlers became one of the United States of America. Time and necessity fathered political divisions within the state and built invisible fences to embrace their influence. Wide expanses of scrub palmetto, mangrove swamp, and sandy beaches remained for years deserted and unchanged. For more than half a century, the finger of land known to Ponce de Leon as Punta Pinal, the location of a freshwater spring, suffered as the political stepchild of its Hillsborough government across the bay. The panorama of the passing years mirrors a way of life unknown to present generations when the tempo of existence was measured only by the passing seasons. No rails, no roads, no rowboats to bring a man to speak his piece before the lawmakers of the day. Schools and roads and public works were paid for. The tax was spent for other things. Tampa Town controlled the votes. History has recorded AD 1911 as the foundation of the Pinellas future, the end of Hillsborough County domination. W.L. Straub, determined editor of a small twice-weekly newspaper, spearheaded a bloodless revolution for the freedom of his homeland, then wrote its birthday headlines. Punta Pinal, the Point of Pines, became Pinellas County. Slowly then, the new replaced the old, and as the years advanced, the sandy trails gave way to roads, and wagon wheels of horse-drawn vehicles were replaced with noisy motor cars. Refugees from winter's grip of ice, like the Spanish explorers of long ago, discovered anew the palms and pines, the sun and sea, and made this place their home. They came en masse, these strangers from afar, and with them came a flood of gold and silver in the coin of the realm. The winter visitor became Pinellas industry. Along palm-lined streets, the Spanish buildings of the day withstand the ravages of time. Tropical gardens abloom with flowering shrubs and stately trees were the fashion of the age, a Shangri-La for winter's refugees. Mounting problems face the county now. More homes, more schools, more power, more utilities, more roads and streets and lots and town sites, more recreation for the ever-mounting tide of winter visitors. The whims of weather, a capricious dollar value on the Wall Street teeter board of ups and downs, these are the hazards of a seasonal economy. But men of vision had a different plan. An industrial empire for Pinellas? Would such a plan invite disaster? Or would it bring prosperity? The challenge of the future was met with courage and with able leadership. Unselfish men gave freely of their time and talents, and their measure of success became the headlines of the day. Tarpon Springs, Pinellas's northern city, once a small village of Greek sponge fishermen, combines old-world charm with modern industry. For generations, the spongemen risked their lives along the ocean floor. Descending to the murky depths, they keep a rendezvous with sharks and other dangers of the coral reefs. Their lives hang by the thread of a rubber hose. The bayfront streets are lined with stalls where prizes of the deep are on display, and 10,000 sponges are offered to buyers of the world, big ones, small ones, every size and shape and form. Hardy seafaring men, their lives spent half above and half below the surface of the waves. Their town, the sponge capital of the world. Yet in the shadow of the fishing fleet, there is much important industry. Victor Chemical's massive giant suggests a castle on the river's edge. Across the city, other plants and modern buildings stand against a backdrop of live oak trees and swaying pines. Around the clock, they add their products to a better way of life, to build a new economy. From raw materials to finished product, workers and machines combine within the walls of modern buildings to meet our daily needs and to supply the markets of the world with all their products and to add the means for happy hours of carefree playtime. Progress, a mixture of the new with the customs of other generations who knew the grandeur of ancient Grecian days, lends enchantment and promise to this city of two worlds. Dunedin in central Pinellas County faces westward along the St. Joseph Sound. Since its founding, it has remained a residential city, surrounded by sun-swept groves of golden oranges. Gracious homes along palm-lined shore-edge drives overlook wide vistas to the Gulf of Mexico and outward to a limitless horizon. The quiet, peaceful way of life has been the lure for all who seek a haven, a retreat from big town ways. Yet there is work for those who find that jobs are needed. Clearwater, Pinellas County seat, a mixture of the days of long ago, when all around were farms and fields and groves, is now a booming resort city on the Pinellas Sun Coast. In the direction of the sunset, man-made islands are an artist's masterpiece of tropical beauty. Visitors from every state enjoy smart shops along the business streets, and homes of lasting charm are everywhere throughout the town. Homes on wheels suggest a newer trend in carefree living, and many fishermen prefer to live aboard their craft. From pier and dock, their voyage is never far to reach the world's best fishing grounds. The gentle Gulf-born waves roll into glistening snow-white sand, where bathers may acquire a coat of tan or disport themselves in the tropic waters of the Gulf of Mexico. The city's plan has set aside a park for industry, and the future promise of more and more prosperity is in the making as modern plants are raised and staffed with trained and expert workers in this old new city by the sea. Pete the Pelican, namesake for Pinellas County's largest city, St. Petersburg. A tourist paradise and for many years the nation's haven for the senior citizen. The Sunshine City boasts a novel weather guarantee. The evening paper is free. Each day there is no sun. World-famed green benches, birthplaces of romance, line the curbside of the business streets, wide landscaped traffic ways which show the foresight of the founding fathers. Once isolated by the wide expanse of Gulf and Bay, St. Petersburg today is linked by super roads and engineering miracles. The Sunshine Skyway, shortcut to the southern mainland, is the gateway to a new economy. The dreams and plans and efforts of all the men who saw a new prosperity for Pinellas suddenly came true. New industry was moving in. Power to turn the wheels of progress is reaching out to every corner of the county. High lines of volts and pipelines of Texas natural gas are the vanguards of the changing times. Famed names and famous firms find helpful promise in a snow-free land, and leaders in their many fields discovered willing workers close at hand. Pinellas, now the center of the magic of the atom, products of the electron, secrets of the universe, will provide a better way of life for all mankind. As time rolls by, more plants for research and for newer products will raise their structures to the sky. A never-ending stream of dollars flows into the pockets of uncounted thousands who are well rewarded for their jobs well done. And as they fan out to north and east and west and south, so does their wealth. Strangled transportation is economic suicide, so streets and roads are building fast to serve the men and women who call Pinellas County home. New industry invites new residents, and they demand new homes. Each passing week records a building boom as open fields become sun-kissed estates. Flowers take the place of grass and weeds and burned-off trees. Spare-time landscape architects work carefully to beautify their grounds. Old-time dark and dreary furnishings have been discarded for a newer home decor. The outside-inside motive shows a trend unknown to northern climes. The children, too, must be provided for. Old, crowded schools are not enough for youngsters of today. Education marches on to meet the needs of youth, and to their responsibility will fall the future of the county, state, and nation. Families, friends, and residents alike, transplanted from afar, or native to the Point of Pines, must be supplied with all the things they need. Stores and markets, goods and service, are being born in new communities, and business prospers. Treasures from across the sea, from foreign lands, and from around the nation change hands on counters everywhere. Streamlined trains whose starting point may well be smothered deep in snow bring many who for years have sought a haven from the cold, a land of promise and prosperity. Others prefer to ride the giant metal birds which settle down on brand new runways. The terminus for the highways in the sky has been expanded twice. It must be done again. In less than half a century, Florida's smallest county, Pinellas, has become its fourth in population and first in new industry. The future is being made possible by progress. And progress? By wheels in the sun.